I'm sitting here with Fiac Moriarty, who we're going to hear next on the Tower Sessions. And Fiac, it's a pleasure to have you here.
Good to be here. Great to be playing music again.
Well, I was just going to say, it's probably one of your first times performing in this capacity since the beginning of the pandemic.
Yeah. First time playing my own stuff since early last year, I'd say, which is madness. Other than playing at home to myself. My kids aren't that interested in hearing my songs, so that's it.
But you told me just as we started talking that you're actually working on a new album at the moment. Has the has the pandemic been a creative time for you, do you feel?
It has. Sometimes hard to get that space, especially when we were homeschooling. But in one way, it was great because I delved into home recording. And I got Logic and I delved into Logic and just went head first and made all the mistakes that you make at the start and just figured out how to do things myself rather than outsourcing or relying on other people to record and kind of more time to, in a way, because it was less work, I had more time to be creative and to read and research what I'm writing about. So it's definitely huge creative benefits to lockdown and the pandemic for me. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And in a lot of the music that you've released, because as well as being your friend, I'm also a fan of your music, there's a huge historical element to your music. And it's obvious, as you just said, it is very well researched. But do you think that this time during the pandemic has led you in a different thematic direction?
I've probably gotten more into the history stuff. My last album, The Revolution, about half of the songs were very much about history. And my first album, I don't think there was any kind of history stuff on there. But I've always been a history kind of nerd. And in the last couple of years, I've gotten very into my family ancestry and going on ancestry.com. And my great-grandfather and his brother were in the Royal Dublin Fusiliers fighting. And I fought in World War One, which is not something I was that interested in because, I mean, I'd be quite Republican, really. But there's great human stories there. And I've been kind of reading a lot about that and how so many Irish men were just mowed down like dogs in Gallipoli, and including my great-granduncle. So I find that very interesting. What made them join up? What drove them? Was it money? Was it loyalty to the crown? And some of them just thought it was going to be an adventure, and they arrived under a hail of Turkish bullets or German bullets or whatever. So I just find it fascinating. And also because it's always been a bit of a taboo in Ireland, and only the last few years we've been able to kind of be a bit mature and say we can commemorate these as well as Connolly and Pearse, who, you know, are obviously big heroes of mine. So I think the road less travelled is kind of more interesting for me, you know. Mm. It's probably too easy for me to write about how brilliant James Connolly is because everybody knows it. So to just get personal about it, just go to my granny's father and her uncle. I was very close with my grandmother, so she would have spoken about them a lot. So it's quite close, you know. Mm-hmm. It's really not that far, that long ago. So even my own cousins and aunties and uncles wouldn't talk about it that much. So the ancestry route really led me into finding out stuff and finding records and military records and what company they were in. So yeah, my history nerdness was tingling a lot.
Well, I'm definitely looking forward to hearing that music when it's released. You've been a sort of an import to Carlow. Originally from Dublin, of course, but after your many years in Carlow, do you finally feel like you're ready to accept that Carlow is your identity now?
Carlow is the greatest place in Ireland.
Yeah.
No, I'm still a Dub. I'm still a Dub. I'll always be a Dub. And I mean, I probably write more about Dublin now that I've left it than I ever did when I was living in the middle. I used to live in Meath Street and loved it, living in the Liberties. And that's where my grandmother is from and all her family who I've been writing about. So, since I've left it, maybe, you know, you get more, get a clearer picture when you're out of somewhere. So I'll always be a Dub, but my kids are Scallionators and they will be, although they kind of have Dublin accents. So I think that won't last too much longer, but no, I've embraced Carlow. I love the town and I love the county, actually, going down to St. Mullins or Rahana, Mount Leinster. I think it's an incredible place. And including actually during pandemic when the 5K and all that was lifted, we kind of got to see the place a bit more, and which was easier to do with less work on, you know. So again, another positive of the pandemic.
Deadly. Well, Fiach, I for one can't wait to hear your set. If you want to check out more Fiach's music, check out Fiach Moriarty online in all the usual places. Fiach, looking forward to hearing you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Nice to be back playing music again. Thinking of becoming a guard or something. Or maybe a professional basketball player or something. There's a song called Faddle Alley. I mentioned Faddle Alley and Dowker's Lane, two streets and the Liberties in Dublin that no longer exist. And the River Poddle disappeared at Faddle Alley underground, went under Dublin Castle, as it still does. And you might remember or recognise a grate in the side of the Liffey walls. That's where the Poddle comes out into the Liffey, just there, just at the Clarence Hotel there. This is about a chase through the Liberties into the Poddle.
On the way through Faddle Alley, left on Dowker's Lane, slum Lord dogs in Cobbled Valley hunt me down again, and stumbling through the empty tenters, through New Market Square, Sunday's funeral masses gather, rosary bead and prayer. Thank you. track and be down. 4, 2, and 6, a half a crown. There's only one place I can't be found, into the puddle and underground. Under the castle and under the boards, the merry song, the laughing hordes, it's getting tight. I'll have to crawl to the light of the great note if you are.
This is my attempt at writing a 1910s music hall kind of song, and this is a man in my imagination, my great granduncle, joining the army in Portobello Barracks to fight, join a big adventure that was World War I.
Well, we climbed up the ladder onto Ormond Quay, and now I'll wash a woman through her coat on me and into me hand through a hot mug of tea. Now you won't catch a death, says she. And I peered all the road to Lower Capel Street, a newspaper boy and nearly dead on his feet. The front of the Times held above his head. I read what the headline said. Come join us, says John, we'll be there together. Come join us, says John, brother and brother. Wherever that fight may be, and sons you'll see fighting for liberty. Come join us, says John. So I pulled up me bootstraps and I hopped 2, 3 to Portobello for to be an enlistee. Sign up to battle with the enemy for to keep small nations free. Come join us, says John, we'll be there together. Come join us, says John, brother and brother. Well, the orange man in Ulster, the Fenian in Munster, will unite and fight through day and night. Join us, says John. And when I return, it's where we shall be, in Francis Street, with all your family. But till then, come join us, says John. Come join us, says
This is a song on the other side of the coin. This is a song based on a poem by Pádraic Pearse called The Mother. And this is my first time ever, I think, using a loop pedal for a gig. I'm about 20 years too late to the party, but we'll see how it goes. A song about a mutt, about love. And this is for my very beautiful wife, Clara.
I kissed you and you cried and whispered your goodbye. For everything we knew, you stretched and you outgrew. But there will be a time when everything will rhyme for you. I crooned a lullaby, you wooed a butterfly and held it in your paw to coo and oo and aah. You set that treasure free, but everything will rhyme, you'll see. In poem and word and song, we breathe and we belong. You took your time, it's true, but there will be a time when everything will rhyme for you.
I'll do one more song, if that's okay. Thanks again to Walter and the Dinry and the powers that be that made this possible. Nice to stand up with a guitar in my hand again. A song called We at Swim.
Heaven sent you to me. When I was calling to the sea, for to wash me clean away. As an island I would stay. And then something caught my eye, and the ocean hushed and slowed. I was blinkered in your life. Locks and waves do ebb and flow. Oh heavens, oh heavens, oh heavens, oh heavens, rescue me. In the silence there was shade. I was cold and so afraid. I was sinking in the dirt. I didn't know what I was worth. Heavens, oh heavens, oh heavens, oh heavens, rescue me. there was a heaven unto you.
Joining us now at the Tower Sessions is one of Ireland's most celebrated singer-songwriters, Luann Parle. It's fantastic to have you here.
It's great to be here, Shane. Lovely to see you.
So, as I remember, you had just launched a new album right as the pandemic struck in February, March 2020. What was that like?
So I had just released the album in February, and it was actually my first album in 10 years. I had released, my last one was 2010. I had an EP in between, but this was like, you know, the first album since then. So I put everything into it all, blood, sweat and tears. I'm so excited for the release, and I came out the 8th of February with a sold out tour. We had a few dates where we actually got to play, which was amazing. And then everything was brought to a halt. So to be honest, I think I was in a state of denial. And I remember when I was sending out posters to venues, I was saying, look, I'll send them anyway. Yeah. You know, thinking it's a couple of weeks, 2 or 3 weeks, you know, and they were saying, maybe hold off. And I was like, no, I'll send them. So you have them. So it was difficult. It was challenging then when that happened. We were brought to a halt. Then I just kind of had to adapt and try and think ways to promote the album from home. So.
But you have kept very active, I've noticed, throughout the whole lockdown period. I mean, I've seen you multiple times online, but also on television as well.
Yeah.
You've kind of kept yourself very active in a time that is incredibly difficult for most musicians.
Yeah, I am someone that likes to keep busy, and I need structure to my day. So I will plan my days out that I'm busy. So lots of songwriting, lots of Zoom co-writes, which was really good, actually. I think a lot of people are Zoomed out now at this stage. But it was really handy for writing with overseas writers. Mm-hmm. So, for example, I got to write with them, Hal Linds again, who I collaborated with on the album. Mm-hmm. And it was great just being able to go into the sitting room, put the computer on, and there was Hal. So in that respect, it was good. Set up the studio at home so that I could record. That was a big thing for me. Mm-hmm. You know, I wanted to be able to do that, and with all the studios closed, it was important that I was able to do that when I needed it. Just keeping myself busy, lots of little projects on the go, and just trying to be creative as possible as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And do you find that in particular with regard to the songwriting, mm-hmm. And between your own songwriting and these Zoom co-writes, do you feel that it's more difficult to be creative in a period like a national and an international lockdown, or do you find that it kind of gave you maybe a new insight or thematically new directions?
I think it, you know, it has its challenges, and some days are good and some days aren't so good. So, yeah, I think to get yourself into a good headspace can be difficult when everything around you is, you know, pretty doom and gloom, and you can't get out, and you can, you know, when we were in the height of the pandemic, we could only walk a couple of kilometres. Yeah. So, yeah, trying to keep the head right was important. But, Yeah, I think the thing is to not put pressure on yourself. So if you do have a co-write or a writing day and things don't go as good, or maybe the song is a bit, it's not the happiest, that's okay, you know, and then on to the next day and the next day. So not to be too hard on yourself, you know.
Mm-hmm. And going back a bit, where is it that your love of music came from, and what is it that brought you into not only performing music, but composing and writing your own music?
So I signed my first record deal when I was 12. There was always music in my house when I grew up in Wicklow. And my dad was a musician. So there was always music in the home. It was just a very natural thing. I started playing guitar when I was 7. I started to sing when I was very young. My mother said I could sing before I could talk. So it just felt like a natural thing to do. And then any opportunities, be it talent competitions or charity shows or cabarets, I was there and I was performing. And I loved it. I just loved it. Then I performed on the Late Late Toy Show when I was 11 with my own song. And I suppose where the songwriting came from was I was always listening to lyrics. And I loved listening to lyrics. And I asked my dad a question one time about... As a child, it was something to do with Christmas or something like that. And he said, well, look, why don't you write it all down and I'll help you put some chords to it. Mm. So that was the song that I ended up playing on the toy show.
Wow.
Then an album deal came from that, signed a record deal, and ever since, I'm still here, so in a way. Yeah, so it seems to be the only path for me.
Wow. Well, I'm really looking forward to hearing your set. If you want to check out more of Luann's music, check out Luann Parle on all the usual places where you find music online. Luann, looking forward to listening to you.
Thank you, it's been a pleasure.
Takes a breath from the evil eye. Our faith is written in the stars. Something old, something new, something borrowed and blue. You got warm hands and a cold heart. It hit me like a rocket hit a meteorite. I didn't see it coming. It made me shiver, it made me high. In the shadows I saw I was flying high, but now I'm slipping on the grass. High, but now I'm slipping on the grass. If you drop a knife, then a man will come. He'll make you feel like the chosen one. But if you drive a fork, then he'll send a stone. You'll feel you're walking on water. It hit me like a rocket hit a meteorite. I didn't see it coming. It made me shiver, it made me high. In the shadows I saw him running. I was flying. But now I'm slipping on the grass. But now I'm slipping on the grass. But now I'm slipping on the grass. But now I'm slipping on the I never wanna come down. I never.
Hello, everybody. My name is Luan Pearl, and I am absolutely delighted to be here today at the Terra Sessions in the Dinnery. So thank you so much for having me here. It's really great to be here and to play. That song was actually a song that was on my album Free, which was released around 2007, I think. And it's a song I don't really play that often, so it's one I thought I'd give a little bit of an outing to. So the next one I'm going to do is, it's a song from my latest album, and it's called Falling For You.
Whispers in the shadows keep me searching all night. The darkness never brightens, the sun never shines. And time moves so slowly, and I'm feeling so blue. I'm falling.
This next song I'm going to do is was actually the second single that I released from my album. And I had only released the album in February, just before we were brought into lockdown in March. And so I had a whole elaborate video planned that I couldn't do. So I thought, what am I going to do? So I put out a message on my Facebook page and I said, it would be amazing if people could just film themselves, just rocking out to the track, just playing along or doing handstands or doing anything fun. And I was overwhelmed with the response. So so you can check that on YouTube. And it's called Change Your Mind.
Small town talk. On the corner of every street, tales of food and water when the morning summer heat. And everyone has a story they want to tell. It's trying to outdo the other in the small town hell. And I trying to change your mind. I seemed like we almost had it all. But I chose freedom, you chose love. I'm searching for something more. But I wouldn't change if we had just one more day. Was it just bad timing, or would we let it slip away? I've been trying to change your mind. I can't stand it, leaving you behind. Though I know she's good for you, and I can see you without me, you're just fine. But every time I'm standing close to you, something in your eyes tells me, oh, oh, oh. I've been trying to change your mind. I can't stand it, leaving you behind. Although I know she's good for you, and I can see you without me, you're just fine. And every time I'm standing close to you, something in your eyes tells me, oh, yeah, something in your eyes tells me, oh, 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 still mine, still mine.
Okay, I'm just gonna have a little sip of water.
All alone with my demons for friends. goodbye.
That was a song from my album I released back in 2010, and it's called Is This Goodbye? So the next one I'm going to do is another one from the new album, although it doesn't feel new anymore. I've been working away on some new songs.
Fare thee well, my true love story. Fare thee well, my true love's gone. He left me for another lover, while I long for pastures on. The autumn comes, a least start for them. All the bright sheets turn to brown. At night the chilly wind starts pouring, blowing cold across my brow. Oh, very well, my true love story. Very well, my true love's gone. He left me for another lover, while I since you stole my time away. But I, a foolish girl, not praying, still wait in vain, still wait in vain. Oh, there thee well, my true love story. There thee well, all alone. The past is gone. Already well, my true love's gone. Already well, my true love's gone. He left me for another lover. All while alone, oh, alone.
Okay, so I just have a couple more songs for you. It's such a treat to be able to play. This song was the title track of the album, the last album, Never Say Goodbye. And yeah, it goes like this.
I closed my eyes last night to feel what it was like when you were to hear you laugh. Oh, how you did laugh. A year has gone so fast, and I find it still that I can't let you go. I guess I never will. I'll so fast, it goes so fast. Some days I long to dream, and your voice just carries me back over the years. I cry my silent tears. I feel you everywhere I go.
Come to the last song now, although I don't know, I'd stay here and I'd play forever. So huge thank you. Thanks to you all for watching. Thanks to everybody here. Thanks to Catherine Martin. for making this all possible. And I'm going to finish with this one. It's a song that I co-wrote with Hal Lynns from Dire Straits. And it's called Lonely World. So thank you. Thanks again. I'm counting down the days and the hours till I'm on the morning train. I dream about a day and night. Sometimes I feel like going insane. Watch the streets for miles and miles when no one knows my name. It doesn't feel like home in a lonely world. I hear the sound of a church bell ringing. Outside the gates, a young girl's crying, holding her mother's hand. It takes me back so long ago from where I stand. It doesn't feel like home anymore. I walk these streets for miles. I long to hear my father's voice when he tells me my skirt's too short. He runs the boys away from the door when they come calling to court. If I could live my whole life through, I'd live it in that town. It doesn't all these streets for miles and miles when no one knows my name. It doesn't feel like home in a lonely world. It doesn't feel like home in a lonely world. Nowhere feels like. Thank you so much. Thank you.